Hi guys, I'm Sysadmin SK. So in this video, I'll show you how you can create affinity rule and anti-affinity rule. So why affinity and anti-affinity rules are used? If there is some condition that this machine should not migrate from one host to another, this machine should not go anywhere, it should be on the same host, the host should not change. After changing some configuration changes or something happens, so what you want, the machine should be on the same host every time till there is any, what you say, server down or something happens. So till the time, the machine should be on the same host you want it. So in affinity rule, what you can do, you can keep two virtual machine on the same host, or you can separate from one host to another, or if you want that these two machines should on the same, this only these hosts, which if you want that era one should be on the host one, two only, and central should be on host three only, it also can be done. So I'll show you whole process of affinity, anti-affinity on the VM base, on the host base, everything will do great. So first we'll go with the affinity rule called VM base. So first of all, we create a rule. So first we'll do for the first two, which not require the group. These two requires the group. So these two requires the group. So we'll do later. First we'll do first two. So what I want is keep virtual machine together. So I'll name give as a together. Okay, and what I will do, I'll just select admin era and the central on the same host. No, I don't want, I want central and era 2 should be on the same host. Okay, I'll just click on okay, rule is enabled, I'll just put okay. If I'll go to the monitor and taskbar, you will see the relocation will has been started, virtual machine migrate. So if I'll go to the host and VM, era 1 is here, era is here, central and era 2 on the same host. You come to know, this is done, this is called affinity rule towards virtual machine. Means I want that these two virtual machines should be together every time. Wherever they go, if you demotion this virtual machine to the second host after the DRS occurs, again it backs to the same host. So first rule is done. What we did is the keep virtual machine on the same host. Keep virtual machine together in any of the host, but should be together. Now we'll go for the second rule. Go to the configure and go to the VM host rule and add. In second, what I will do is I'll separate. So I'll give the name as a separate and I'll add machine. I'll add machine, and what I will do now, era 1 and admin era. Era 1 and admin era should not be on the same host. They should be differ from the host. On the different host. So I'll click OK. Then era 1 and admin era will not be on the same host. So I'll click OK. As it's done, restarted. Remotion was done. Era 1 is here. And admin era is here. They won't come on the same host. They separated from the host. So you can see now it's migrated. If you want that, I can show you here also. If I'll go to your task, see, era 2 is migrated. Era 2 is migrated. So if I'll go to the cluster admin, I'll click on monitor. And in a taskbar, if you go, you can see the machine relocation is done. See, reconfigure cluster, migrate virtual machine. So machine has been migrated from the other host. So I'll show you in the video also. If I will show you the what I will do now. You think that I have changed also. So what I will do, I'll see admin era and era on the same host. So first of all, admin era and era on the same host, I want to differ from the other host. I don't want, then era and admin era should be on the same host. Okay. So what I will do, I'll edit the setting only. I will not create a next tool. In separate, I'll edit the setting. So I'll click on cluster. So it will come to know is working or not. Okay. So what I will do, on a cluster I have selected. Configure. So in a rule, now what we did is we have checked that this not, I'll remove this. Okay. And I'll add era, which was on the same host. Okay. So I'll keep it okay and I'll do okay. Okay, now we'll check VM. See why it is not migrated, I'll tell you. I'll just power on this machine. Right click and power on. As soon as I'll power on, the machine will get. So it's not allowing the machine to migrate. I will power off other machine due to some reason it was not happening. So what I will do, I'll just power off. Okay. Yes, it's done. So now I'll power on this machine. So I'll check in edit setting, is there any problem with this machine? And this is the VM code data store is also there. So what I will do, I'll power off this because we have large number of CPUs, so due to that we were getting an error. So now I'll power on. Era is having problem. So now I'll go to this. Okay. So now what I will see, era is here, no? So what I will do, instead of era, on this host, on the 03, okay, next, in 03, okay, so it is selected 03, put max and finish. So now era 1 will come here. Yes, now era 1 is here. So we'll go to the configure, we'll click on cluster admin, we'll go to the configure in separate, we'll add it, and instead what we'll do, we'll add era 1. Okay, so I have added era 1, I'll make it okay. Now we'll go and we'll see on the virtual machine, and era 1 and admin era is on the same location. So what I did is, I just power on. As soon as the machine will power on, it will separate out. See, as the rule powered on, it's not coming to the, it went to the some other location, but it didn't stop with the admin era. So our issue means our rule are working fine. So now what we'll do, and other tool. Now what we'll do, we'll just go to this and we'll create a two groups called eras and we'll add era 1 and era 2. Era 1 and era 2. Okay. And we'll click OK. One created, and we'll add one more group called host group. So air host VRP, and I'll add 2 and 3. Okay. Now two hosts are added. So I got a group. So now I'll create a rule, add the rule. In this virtual machine to host. Okay, so we'll V to H. VM group era must run on the host in group. Should run on the host in group, must not run on the host group, should not run on the host group. So must run on the host, on this host group. So means eras. Eras in the sense, eras means era 1 and era 2 should be running on 2 and 3 only. So when I'll click OK, I'll go and I'll check. I'll power on this also. If I'll go to 3, OK. Era 2 is getting powered on. See, so era 2 is working on 2, and now migrating virtual machine has been started migration. So as soon as migration complete, we'll see what we have configured is V2H edit option. Eras, so we'll go to the group, and in eras, era 2 and era 1 should work, be on number host 2 and host 3. So era 2 is on host 2, migrating. So every machine we are migrating to each other, so we wait till migration complete. And keep it in mind, while creating this rule, the rule should not affect to each other. Means in this you have done the should be on the same host, and another you have did on other host, so it may compile and it will not work. But we'll wait. See, 97% is done. So central is migrating, and admin era is also migrating. So we'll wait, because admin eras are vCenter server. So is 90% done? Yes. So what we do, we are on the VM tab. So central is done. Now you can see, I'll click on this. See, era 2 is at 3, and era 1 is at 2. So now you can say, you can see that the we have created the host group and the VM group. So the host is working on this. Means what we had created, the rule was two VMs should work, should run on two hosts. So what we did is era 1 and era 2. So era 2 is working on number 2 and era 1 is working on 3. So our rule is working fine. There is no problem with the rule. So we'll go in the next, and we'll go to the configure. and we'll create a rule, VM host rule. In this, we'll add the rule. And what is the rule is virtual machine to virtual machine. What it is? So select cluster VM group. Restart for VM group on restart. So era, the VM dependency restart condition must be met before continuing to. So we'll do it here. So must should run on this host. So we'll end up with this. You come to know that how you can configure the affinity rule and the anti-affinity rule towards how you can keep two virtual machines on the same host, how you can separate two virtual machines, how you can force the machine to run on those hosts only. So we'll end up with this, and next lecture will come with the next video.